Hello, I'm Mike. Welcome to our 9-part video series, 76 Proven Tactics to Drive Traffic to Your Website. Today, we'll be talking about technical improvements that'll do just that. So you've got your website all set up, but you're unsure how to drive traffic to your website. This video series is devoted to showing you 76 tried and true methods to do just that. Alicia, MJ, and I are covering topics such as content marketing, creating communities, social media, and more. But before we get too far, remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content, such as videos in this series. And I want you to know that in the description below, we're going to have loads of resources that'll dive deeper into many of the topics I'll be presenting today. All right, let's get started. Another aspect of SEO that determines how much traffic your site will get is its technical health. In order for search engine bots to find, crawl, and index your site, there are some technical elements you need to tick off. Let's check them out. Number 42 on our list, follow technical SEO best practices. Technical SEO is the process of optimizing your site for Google's crawlers. It is an important step in getting traffic to your site. If Google can't find, crawl, and index your site, you won't rank. No ranking equals no organic search traffic. It is called technical SEO because it is less about the content of your site and more about the infrastructure. Technical SEO can be a big topic, but in terms of getting the best practices down, here are the things you want to do. Specify a preferred domain, www or no www. Optimize your robots.txt file. Optimize your site's URL structure. Have a logical site structure and website navigation. Use breadcrumbs to improve UX. Add structured data markup. Set up canonicals. Set up and optimize your 404 pages. Use 301 redirects. Have an XML sitemap. Install an SSL certificate. Make sure your website loads fast. Make sure your website is mobile friendly. Set up Google Search Console. This is by no means an exhaustive list, but if you can check off everything above, you are on the right track for a healthy site. Again, make sure to check out the resources in the description below. Number 43, submit your site to search engines. You want your site to show up on Google and Bing, right? Then you need to submit your site to search engines. Actually, this process is very quick. Most of the work is done for you, but it's worth doing so you have control of indexation in the future. Search engines don't technically require you to submit your site, but there are plenty of scenarios where it makes lots of sense, such as with new sites with little to no backlinks, rehauled sites with new content and structure, recently hacked sites, or when a big chunk of updated content is now available. Manually submitting your site to Google and other search engines should cut down on the time required to get re-indexed properly, hence gaining organic traffic regularly flowing towards you. Number 44, improve SERP click-through rates with GSC data. Click-through rate, or CTR, is the percentage of searchers who click through to your website from the Google search results. Here's the great thing. By improving your CTR, you can effectively increase traffic. To see your CTR, go to Search Console and then Performance. Make sure your average CTR is selected and choose Queries. From here, you will be able to see your best and worst queries in terms of CTR. Some ways you can improve your organic CTR are improve page titles, clear and descriptive URLs, improve meta descriptions, add structured data, and improve page speed. Find out more in our in-depth guide on using Google Search Console, linked in the description below. Number 45, fix lost link juice on 404 pages. When you delete a linked page, add an incorrect URL to a page, or incorrectly change a URL, a broken link is created. These are bad for user experience. No one wants to go buy some Legos and be greeted with this 404 page. Or maybe you do. That's a pretty great 404 page. When a search engine is crawling your site and they find dead links, it can stop the spiders from crawling your site, which can stop it from being indexed. In other words, when searchers and/or web crawlers browse through your site and click on the link, they may be directed to a page with a 404 error. I don't know about you, but when this happens, I either get a bit annoyed with the website in question or just leave. Don't take that risk. Go find and fix any potential broken links. Number 46, boost authority with interlinks. Interlinks, or internal links, are links that point from one page on your site to another page on the same site. You have seen them countless times before. Interlinks usually occur naturally when you are referring to past content or related pages in your content. Adding internal links can help visitors and search engines navigate your own website, help to establish an information structure, and spread link juice or authority throughout your site. Number 47, make sure your site is responsive. Almost everyone has a smartphone, and almost everyone browses websites on their mobile device. As of July 2020, there were 4.17 million unique mobile internet users. That's a lot of potential mobile visitors to your site. Google recognized this with its introduction of mobile-first indexing. If you don't have a responsive website, here's why you should. It improves site usability for visitors. It will load faster. It will reduce bounce rate, and it may improve social sharing. Number 48, enhance SERP appearance with Schema. Also known as structured data, Schema is a markup easily read by search engines. It makes it easier for search engine crawlers to find and index your page because it gives search engine bots more information about your site. Your site can get rich snippets, which can improve your CTR. If you're featuring reviews on your site, you could score rich snippets like this one here. We've actually got a more detailed guide on how to add Schema markup to a WordPress site, which we will link in the description below. Number 49, make sure your site is fast. We've touched on this a bit already, but how fast your site loads does affect SEO. Page speed is a direct ranking factor and can also affect rankings indirectly via increased bounce rate. Page speed is important for users. Think about it. If a web page is loading slowly for you, what do you do? Do you wait for it to load or do you go somewhere else? Chances are you leave. Faster loading pages are more efficient for keeping people on your site. And Google knows this too. That's why way back in 2010, they announced that page speed counts as a ranking factor for SEO. John Mueller of Google says to make sure that your web page loads in less than 2 to 3 seconds. When it comes to speeding up your site, there are a few things you can do to boost performance, like compress images, use a lightweight and fast WordPress theme, and have a good hosting setup available to deliver high performances. If you want to geek out on page speed, we've got plenty of helpful resources to browse through in the description below. Take some of the tactics from this series and apply them to your site, and you'll be well on your way of increasing traffic. Try them out, see what effect they have on your site traffic, and if one doesn't work for you, try another one. And if it does, double down and do more. Which tactics have you tried? Where have you seen success in driving traffic to your site? Let us know in the comments below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to get notifications for the remaining videos in this series, and of course, other tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.